six is bad, a seven is worse. Higher or lower, it's your choice on Cut Sharks. And here's the host of Cut Sharks, Hugh Perry.
Thank you. Six is bad, a seven is worse, higher or lower, it's your choice. That sounds more like Brooklyn than Phoenix, Arizona, Fred Flickstein, but thank you for that opening poem. I got another poem for you. That's for Fred in his poem, but I have another one.
This poem was sent in by Ann Warren, who's 14 years old, from Cascade, Maryland. And she sent in, listen to this, Gene. I like poems just like Gene Wood, only his are bad and mine are good.
Let's bring out our champion who's going to play the money card, Jeff Wadding. Hello, Jeff. Excuse me.
Thank you. Good to see you too, Jeff.
You are doing very well, our theater manager who has won $8,400 for the money card.
Thank you.
Are you feeling lucky now?
Yes, very lucky, Jim.
Let's get to it. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Hop up there, Jim.
Let's do it well this time, maybe better. You won $200 in the last game, which of course is yours to keep with a brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut.
We are going to give you new money, new deck of cards, and there's $200 on the bottom level in these three cards. See how we light everything up for you, Jeff, and we give you $200 on the next level. And three more cards. Minimum bets are $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half your money. Jeff, you did well the first time. Let's do it again. Here's $200. As in the game, you have a choice of two base cards on the bottom level. Remember, when you change up to the second level, you can change your base card, and you can change your base card again before you make that big bet. Right now, you've got $200 and this base card. It is a jack. You want to play it?
I like that, Hooker. I'll bet $100 it's lower.
$100 lower than a jack? It is a four. Very much lower.
300, and it's higher.
The whole thing, $300 higher than a four? Yes, with a six.
Probably get
to 600
still now.
I bet 100 that it's higher. No high, one high card so far. Higher.
Let's see a big one. $100 higher than a six? Yes, a nine.
Up to 700, up goes the 9, we'll give you the other 200, you've got 900, do you want to play that 9?
No, let's toss it out, Jim.
You can change the 9. Ace. Next card off the top of the deck is a 6. Little better card, you've got $900 and a 6, Jeff.
I haven't seen that many low cards out. I'm going to go $100 and go against the odds and say lower, feeling lucky.
Lower.
Feeling lucky.
Very much against the odds, about 7 cards worth. $100 lower than a 6. Oh, no, it's an ace. But it only costs you $100, and you've got an ace now with $800, Jeff.
The whole thing lower. $800 lower.
$800 lower than an ace.
Yes.
All right.
A
1,600 and a 5.
600. 600, that's higher, Jim. Let's get a good big card.
$600 higher than a 5. It is
all
a queen.
Right. $2,200 and up goes the queen. Do you want to play it on the big bet or change it?
I'll play it, Jim. Nice.
And you must bet at least $1,100. Jeff, you've got $2,200 and a queen. What's your big bet?
Oh, I'll bet $1,200 on that lady that it's going to be lower.
$1,200 lower than a queen.
In it! For $3,400 in cash. Way to go. Just had one bad card again, but you came back great. Super card again. Come on down, Jeff. Congratulations. And in 2 matches in cash, Jeff, you are up to $11,800. That's more than I made this year. We'll meet a new challenger right after this, so don't go away. Back with our champion, Jeff Wine. With $11,800, you're doing very well.
Good thank player. You, Jim. Thank you. This is a super, super group here.
Good.
Super.
I didn't do it. Let's open the board and get to the cards. Janice and Bettina, if you will, load in the cards, and we'll meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. Marla Schramm. Hi, Marla. Nice to meet you.
How are you doing, Jeff?
Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Say hello to Jeff.
Oh, he's a real winner.
He's a good player. Tell us about yourself.
Well, my name is Marla Schramm. I'm currently living in Santa Monica. I'm a court reporter. I love water skiing, snow skiing, all houseplants, and I have an identical twin sister.
Good. How is it growing up as a twin?
Very interesting.
Yeah. I've got to ask you one thing as a court reporter. Okay. Are you really writing anything when you're sitting there typing on that little box?
Oh, you better believe every word.
Really?
Every cough, everything.
Good to have you here, Marla. Good
Thank
luck to both of you.
Thank
Each player has a deck of 52 playing cards. They're shuffled. The players cut them before we go on the air. Jeff, the champion, will play the upper cards, the red cards. Marla, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. Before you can begin calling high-low on the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question. And we start the best 2 out of 3 match with a question to you, Jeff. We asked 13-year-old boys, if a talent scout offered you a contract to star in a television series, but you had to dress as a fairy princess, would you do it? How many 13-year-old boys said they would dress as a fairy princess?
Oh, that takes a lot of razzing to do that. And I don't know if they realize about the money. I think it's kind of low. I'd say about 38.
38 13-year-olds would take the part as the fairy princess, Marlo.
I'm sure they'd have a lot of prompting from their parents about that, being 13 years old. I'm going to say it's going to be a touch higher.
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 If it is higher, Marla, you'll go to the board first. If not, it'll be Jeff. And the actual number of 13-year-old boys who would dress as a fairy princess to star in a television series is 32, not higher, Jeff. Your card is a 10. Whenever you win the question, you have the right to change it.
I'll change it this time, Jim.
Next card off the top of the deck is a 5. Good,
that's
James.
That's better. Let's go high, Jim. High.
Higher than a 5? Yes. With another 10.
I had a 10 back. Let's go low.
You got to look.
Yeah,
I'm lower than a 10. It is all a 2. Right. Very much lower.
Got to go high, Jim. Got to go high.
A 2. A 3.
All the way, Jim. All the way.
For the first
all
game.
All the way.
This is higher. Yes. With a 5. Oh.
What's that up for game 2, Dennis? Yes, when you get going on those hot streaks, you just knock them off.
Oh, incredible.
And we'll set up with the same 2 decks of cards. Marla, you didn't get a chance.
I didn't get a chance to do anything. He is on a hot streak. No,
maybe you'll get
it.
On a streak this time.
Oh,
you need this game, and the question's going to you, Marla. We asked 100 single women between the ages of 21 and 40. Have you ever made a fool of yourself over a man?
Oh,
how many women said they had made a fool of themselves over a man?
They would be lying if they didn't admit it. Once in their life, I would have to say, I'd say 78.
78 women have made a fool of themselves over a man, Jeff.
Oh, I don't know if it's really that high. I think by the time they get to that age, they know what they're doing. I think it's lower.
What do you mean when they get to that age, 21 to 40?
Well, you know, 16, it would be higher. But
how old are you, Jeff?
23.
Well, I guess 21 to 40 would be that age to Jeff. Yeah, you say lower. The actual number of single women who have made fools of themselves over a man is 67. It's lower, Jeff.
Good cards.
You've been getting them. An ace.
Oh, yeah.
Lower, Jim. Lower
than an ace.
It is a 7.
I'll freeze.
Move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away from you. Jeff, the question to you. We asked 100 marriage counselors across the country. Who are more sexually promiscuous, men or women? How many professional marriage counselors said men are more sexually promiscuous?
Whoa.
I don't know if you heard that lady's voice out of the audience there say 100, friends.
Well, being of the same sex and knowing the friends I know, I think it's pretty high. I say 80.
80?
80.
Professional marriage counselors. Men are more sexually promiscuous. He says 80, Marla.
I like his... I agree with him, but I think it's going to have to be a touch lower.
You say lower than that.
Lower.
The actual number of marriage counselors who said men are more sexually promiscuous is 89, not lower, Jeff.
Somehow I'm not sure if that's a compliment, Jeff.
You've got a 7. You want to change it?
Let's get rid of it, Jim.
Changing the 7 to a 3.
All right, great card. Higher.
Higher than a 3.
Yes,
a 6.
Let's go higher again.
A 6. Oh, no. A 5 is lower.
That is one of the few mistakes that Jeff has made. And Marla, you get a free chance to play a 9. You didn't win the question, you cannot change it.
Okay, it's going to be lower.
Lower than a 9. Yes.
Yes.
Six.
Yes. Okay, come on, it's going to be higher.
Air
higher.
Six. It is.
Okay, I'm definitely going to freeze. Have to freeze.
Marla freezes with a 1-card advantage as we fill in the spaces. Question to you, Marla. We asked 100 women. The last time you cried, was it because you were sad or because you were happy? How many women said the last time they cried, they were happy?
Oh, I'd like to think it would be a lot, but I'm going to have to say. I was going to say something close to that. 35.
35. Did you bring along a Greek chorus with you, Marla?
Yeah, I have some friends up there.
She says 35 women cried when they were happy rather than sad, Jeff.
Well, I agree with that. I think more women would cry when they're sad. I think lower.
Lower than that?
Yes. Yes.
The actual number of women who said the last time they cried they were happy is 25. It's lower, Jeff.
Yes.
Be good. Be good.
You've got a 3, Jeff. Do you want
to play it? We're playing. Go higher.
Higher. Than a 3? Yes,
oh,
for the
good
king.
Good card. Lower.
Jeff. Lower than a king.
A 4. All the way. Higher.
Higher for the championship.
No!
A 2. And you lose all 3 cards. A break from Marla. Play off the 8 and call this, Marla.
Oh, mercy. Okay, this is going to be higher.
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 Higher than an 8. No! A 5. Could not advance. Jeff needs 3 cards. Marla needs 2. Sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Jeff. We asked 100 men, very simply, did you shave this morning? How many men said yes?
Oh, I shave every morning. I think almost all of them shave every morning. I'd say about 88.
88 shave that morning, Marla.
I'm glad he said that. I'd have to say higher.
Higher.
I'd have to say higher because it's such a common practice. It's almost like brushing your teeth. You get up and shave.
Higher.
Higher.
The actual number of men who shave that morning is 70, not higher, Jeff. You need 3 cards. Marla needs 2 cards. You've got the decision. Do you want to play it or pass it?
It's all yours, Marla.
All right, Marla, you cannot change the 8. You need both cards. If you can get them both, you've tied it up. One mistake,
okay.
Jeff wins the championship.
It is definitely going to be higher this time.
Higher than
higher.
8? It wasn't
higher.
The last time. Is it this
higher.
Time? Yes!
This is really, really rough. The next card is going to be lower.
Lower than a 10.
Please.
Oh. No! It is not lower! And Jeff and Sutton have reached the championship again.
Oh, Marla, you came so close.
Thank
you.
Thank
you for joining us. Marla Schramm. Jeff, come on down here. Congratulations once again.
Thank you. Thank you.
We'll play the money card. Jeff's got $12,000 already. Money cards right after this.
Back with our champion, Jeff Wine. You ready to go again?
Yeah, I'm getting used to this. This is great. This is great.
Now let's open the board and get to the money card. Jeff, step on up there.
You've done very well so far. Hope you keep it up. Once again, brand new deck of cards, all shuffled and cut.
Janice will deal them out in her own inimitable fashion, never making a mistake in her entire life. How's that for putting the pressure on you, Jan? You almost dropped one. Of course, your minimum bets are $50 till you get to the top card where you must bet at least half the money. But you know that by now. You've done so very well, Jeff. What? Your neck and legs are getting what?
Weak.
Don't. Hang in there. Here's $200. Does that make your legs feel a little stronger? We'll start you on the bottom line with this base card, Jeff. It is a 5.
That
you
helps.
Want it?
I want it. Let's go. 150, it's higher. 150, it's higher.
By the way, $150 higher than a 5? It is an ace! Wow, he's lucky.
35, Jim. Excellent. All of it, the whole bundle, it's lower. $350
lower than an ace. It is an ace.
Yes, for $700.
All right. I'll say 100 that it's lower.
$100 lower than a 9. Yes, an 8.
All right.
$800 up goes the 8. We'll give you the other $200. You've got $1,000. And now that great change, if you'd like, do you want to change that 8?
Let's get rid of it, Jim. Let's get rid of it. Here's something good.
Nice attitude. You can change that 8 to A three.
That's
not
great.
Too bad.
That's great. The whole thing, Jim. The whole thing, it's higher.
All
the
or nothing.
Thing.
For $2,000, if this is higher than a three, it is very much higher.
Great card. All of it, Jim, that it's lower.
All of it again.
All of it, Jim.
$2,000 lower than a king.
Yes!
A three again!
4,003!
All 4,000, Jim, that it's higher. Be good.
It gets harder to make that bet with all of it as the money adds up. $4,000 higher than a three.
$8,000. And again, you can change that face card before the big bet.
Let's get rid of it, Jim. Let's get rid of it.
See if we can make a good change. Instead of an eight, we have a queen.
That's good.
You've got 8,000 and a queen. What is your big bet?
$7,000. Then it's lower. Be good.
$7,000.
$7,000, it's lower.
Jeff, you are at least going to get $1,000 out of these money cards. But if this is lower than a queen, you will finish it with $15,000. Oh. Lower than a queen? Yeah!
You are sensational.
Thank you, Jim. Come
on down here. Now, without looking at that, you know how much money you want?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe I have to pay for my car, probably.
I think so. Jeff Y, you have now won $27,000.
Thank you, Jim.
We'll be right back.
Right after this.
Jackie, Jeff Wine.
Jeff, what were you saying when you came in to see if I was going on the show? You almost left.
Yes, I thought I was fooling myself getting into that room with all these people. I just
didn't think that they'd pick you, huh?
No, I thought I was fooling myself.
Well, you've sure fooled a lot of people. You're up to $27,000.
Jeff, I must ask you. Janice was asking me to ask you this. Some of the terms you use. What is the word you use for a jack?
Jack's a hooker.
Jack is a hooker.
Queen is a lady. King is a cowboy.
Oh, a jack is a hooker. I never knew that. Son of a gun.
You.
Would you load in the cards with two brand new decks of cards there, Janice? And we'll meet a new challenger on Card Sharks.
Carol Phillips. Hello, Carol. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Jim.
Would you tell us about yourself?
Surely. My name is Carol Phillips, and I live in Diamond Bar. I'm engaged to be married, and we're about to form our own Brady Bunch. Between us, we have a 6-year-old dancer, a 7-year-old soccer player, a 14-year-old girl chaser, a 14-year-old all-star soccer player, an 18-year-old roper, who is a girl, and a 19-year-old runner who's studying to be a veterinarian.
That's a Brady Bunch. Good luck, Carol.
Thank you. I'm going to need it.
You'll play the blue card. Jeff, the champion, the red card's on top.
Jeff, we have 100 married men. Have you ever looked at your mother-in-law and said to yourself, I wish I could punch you right in the nose? How many men said yes?
Oh, I don't know. I don't think that's that high. My girlfriend's mother is dynamite. She's just dynamite. I'd say about 30.
30?
I've wanted to punch their mother-in-law in the nose, Carol.
I disagree. You know that old adage about mothers-in-law. I'm going to say it's higher than that.
Higher! Well, the actual number of married men who wish they could punch their mother-in-law in the nose is 25, not higher, Jeff.
Jeff, your base card is?
A jack. You want it?
I want that. Let's go lower, Jim. Lower.
That's a hooker, right,
yeah,
Jeff?
Yeah, okay. Good hooker.
Lower than a jack. Oh, no, it's a king.
Nice cowboy.
Free chance for Carol to play a nine.
I'm going to say lower, Jim.
Lower than a nine. Yes, a five.
All right. I'm going to go on and say higher.
Higher than a five.
Yes.
Queen.
I love it. I love it. Lower.
Risking those two and this one lower. Yes, an eight.
Freeze.
Freezing it. Carol needs one card to win the first game of the match. Janice will fill in the spaces, and we'll fill in a bit of your knowledge about these important products. Don't go away. That is
That's about all the time we have.
Look, Carol, it'll be a family of eight when you all get together,
yes,
right?
Yes, eight is enough.
Eight is enough. I hope you all get together with us next time we play Card Sharks. Bye-bye for now.
A representative of the studio audience may receive Franciscan's new kaleidoscope dinnerware. Mix and match the four dazzling colors to create a multitude of settings for any mood, any event. Safe in dishwasher, oven, and microwave, plus three-piece microwave cookware set furnished by Franciscan. And some of our contestants will receive West Bend's Electric Oriental Wok for international entertaining or everyday meals. It's ideal for stir-frying, simmering, and stewing. And be everything you could be with Mary Kay Cosmetics. Skin care and glamour cosmetics presented to you in your home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics, Dallas, Texas. And the 22-piece Master Mechanic Multi-Drive Socket Set from True Value Hardware Stores, who combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations. And the Wave by the makers of Lava Light simulates the ocean in motion. Soothing, fascinating, incredibly realistic, perfect conversation piece for home or office. The Wave by Lava Light. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.